Kullback-Leibler Divergence, or KL Divergence, is a measure of how one probability distribution differs from another. If we have two probability distributions, P and Q, mathematically, KL Divergence will look something like this. Now let's show KL in action. Let's say, for your birthday last year, you got a lot of presents. And because we're statisticians, we recorded the height, width, and colour of all of your presents. This year for your birthday, you got the same amount of presents, but in similar but different colours and sizes. So we recorded those too. Now we want to compare how different your presents from this year were to last year. First, we pick a column to examine. In this example, we will pick height, and we'll turn these columns into probability distributions. This means we should calculate the likelihood of a value in the dataset falling between particular ranges. These ranges should be the same between the 2020 and the 2021 datasets. From now on, we can refer to the 2020 height probabilities dataset as P and 2021 as Q. Now it's time to calculate the KL divergence of each range boundary, starting with the boundary 20cm to 29cm. For this boundary, our value P of X is 18 and Q of X is 24. Let's refer back to the equation of KL divergence. Once we plug in our values for P of X and Q of X, we can calculate our KL value for this individual boundary. This gives us -5.17. Now we can calculate this for every single boundary. We can already begin to make some observations of the datasets. Notice how, if the value of the second dataset is larger than the first, we get a negative value, and if it's smaller, we get a positive value. We can also see that for the boundary 40 to 49 centimetres, our probabilities are both 19, and this results in a boundary KL divergence of exactly 0. Cool, right? Now we want the KL divergence of the entire column, not just the individual boundaries. To do this, we simply sum up all the individual KL divergence values. And there we have it. 1.56 is our Kullback-Leibler divergence of the height of presents between 2020 and 2021. Since KL divergence is a scale between 0 and infinity, the closer our value to 0, the more similar our datasets are. Before we leave, there are some things to know about KL divergence. This metric is not symmetrical. That means the KL divergence of P to Q does not equal the KL divergence of Q to P. KL divergence also has limits when it comes to probability distributions that equal 0, specifically on the Q dataset. This will cause a divide by 0 error and will result in the KL divergence reaching infinity, so it's best to keep that in mind. In the field of data science, KL divergence has many applications. Most notably, KL divergence is considered a loss function, which are functions used to measure the difference between a predicted value and an actual value with the intention of making machine learning models more accurate. KL divergence can also be used to detect feature drift in machine learning models by comparing the data used to train the model against live data it is using to score. Thank you for watching our video on Kullback-Leibler divergence, and let us know what other topics you'd like us to cover here in the future.